What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. My name is Corey, also known as that TCG guy. It's, you know, I definitely haven't not posted videos in like a month. I don't know what you're talking about. I've been doing stuff this whole time. I don't know why you would even question me. So hey, look, I remember I said I was gonna do all those videos and then I didn't do them. Here we are. And this totally, I'm not phoning in this video at all. This is completely, like, you know, I thought about this long and hard. The fact that today is, you know, October 7th. Well, I guess it was October 7th. It's now October 8th when I'm filming this. But whatever, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. And, you know, there was two product releases today. Absolutely has nothing to do with why I'm posting a video. Why would you even think that? That doesn't make any sense to me. It's crazy talk. It is October, or was October 7th, now October 8th, and I got my hands on one of the 40K Warhammer Commander decks, the Universes Beyond stuff. These are insanely hard to get a hold of, apparently. Apparently a lot of people pre-ordered them. And you know, it took a little while, but I got one. I also have one coming in the mail. I have the Swarm one, the Teamer one coming in the mail, even though I'm taking a couple of the cards out for another deck that I built, which you'll hear about soon. I wanted to get one that I could just, you know, if someone wants to jam a Warhammer game or something, I can do it. And also, I mean, I heard that these decks are really good. So I figured I got one. I also have some Unfinity stuff, which I will be doing a stream opening them maybe tomorrow night, maybe Sunday. I don't know. We'll figure it out. But I wanted to crack open this, see what's inside of it, see what makes this different than a typical Commander Precon, besides the glaringly obvious. And just give you an idea of what you can expect when you pick one of these up, if you can pick one of these up. Now, this one isn't one of the fancy ones. This is just one of the regular standard Warhammer ones. I believe I paid, my local game store, Battlegrounds, Norton, Massachusetts. If you're in Southeast Mass, please go check them out. They're super awesome. This one, this 40K Warhammer Commander Precon, Ruinous Powers, this was $69.99 over there. So it's, you know, it's a bit pricey, but again, these things are flying off shelves. People's pre-orders are being canceled like crazy. So, you know, if you want one of them, pick it up if you think it's worth it for you. Hopefully this video helps you decide that. And if not, maybe you already pre-ordered them. Maybe you already got some. But, you know, we'll see. But let's crack this open and see what we got. All right. So here we go. We got the deck itself. Oh, shit. I'm from last night. Whatever. Here's the deck itself. Here's the box. This is, like I said, the Ruinous Powers deck. This is the Grixis one. I haven't looked too much into these. I wanted the shooter guy, the guy who does the pingers, from that Swarm deck. That's really, I mean, that's the one that I was like, oh, yeah. But yeah, so let's, probably opening this thing, like, terribly. Everyone's like, what are you doing? All right, so you have the box. Toss that over there. So it looks like we have the same typical, though it's a bit different, of the packaging itself. So here we have it says, let the galaxy burn, look at that. Now this is still just printed on here. This isn't like a token, though this thing over here does look like something that comes off, and we have a couple back here as well. So let's pop these guys out. So here's the box comes separate. Looks like you have to actually you're not putting the box together, but you are assembling the box essentially. So there's that. This rips out for some reason or another. And then this comes out of the side. And then this rips out for some reason or whatever. And then you have all the little planeswalker tokens and shoot counters. I don't know what those are. Looks like little buttholes. The crossroads of humanity. And then this guy pops out for some reason or another. I'm not going to do all the tokens. You guys see them. And then we have one of the life counters, which everyone just throws away. Little thing, whatever that is. And then you have the deck itself. So not too much different from a typical pre-con deck as far as what comes in the box. The cards are not actually in a box ready to go when you open them, apparently. They make you do that. And then also, this plastic is like puzzle box. There we go. So I'm not going to go through each card. We're not going to, like, rifle through them all. Just want to kind of take a look at the frame, see what kind of stuff I haven't seen these in person yet, so. All right, so here we have Abandon the Despoiler. Pretty nice. And this is just like a standard foiling. Like, I know the fancy ones come in like a fancy foil. And then Belloc the Dark Master, or Belcor, excuse me. Belcor. These look pretty nice. These are cool. And then it looks like, yeah, each of the cards has its own neat little Warhammer frame, which is cool. And apparently there's a ton of new cards, like 100 and something new cards for the set. But then there's also a bunch of reprints in like Warhammer art, which is really cool. Like Worn Power Stone, Baron Moore, look at that. Crumbling Necropolis. This is really cool. Commander Sphere, Wayfarer's Bauble has new art. Command Tower has, like, everything's got new art for the most part. Like, this is all themed around Warhammer, which you would expect. That's kind of what, you know, Blood for the Blood God, there it is. This was a card that I was really digging, really looking forward to. Oh, hey, this card comes in here. Huh, I thought that came in the other deck. But yeah, this is really, really, really nice looking. These are super cool cards. So yeah, tokens look cool. Yeah, I totally phoning this one. I felt really bad. I wanted to get you guys a video, and just picking this up, I thought it'd be neat to, you know, take a look at them and see what comes in the box, see how the cards differ, you know, in comparison to typical Magic cards. I mean, the frames are super cool. You have that Universes Beyond. All of them look like they have that triangle at the bottom. Even the lands, even the non-legendaries, all the cards have that little stamp. Looks super cool. I'm super excited to get this thing sleeved up and taken for a test drive. I think I'm going to be doing this, next Saturday, a 40K pod with one more game and a few other people. So super excited for that. And then, yeah, this pile of cards here is going to be a deck based off of Grayson Starn, the guy who does the pings. So expect a deck tech on that soon. I promise I'm gonna stick up with videos. I'm very sorry that they have been lacking, and I'm gonna stay a lot better with those. But one more piece here before I get going. If you did sign up for the July Patreon, where I promised you a free pack of Dragon Shield sleeves, they have now come in. Here they are in all their glory. They are here. I will be reaching out to all the patrons on that tier to get your addresses so I can send you all these plus the stickers that you got for the just being a patron that month, and they'll be coming out soon. But I finally got my hands on them. Super excited to get them in your hands, and excited to see what you do with them. But yeah, that's all I got for you tonight. Thank you so much. Again, expect the deck tech on Grayson coming out soon. Also, I think I'm going to be doing a box opening of Infinity, I think just on Twitch. You can find me on Twitch every Tuesday and Thursday, 10 p.m. Eastern. I stream Commander with my friends and some other stuff. So be sure to come check out that as well. And that's all I got for you. So until next time, catch you later.